Welcome back there, boys and girls, for the next exciting episode of Flip Class from the Classroom. This video will be especially weird because right in the middle, there may or may not be a switch of facial hair and or clothing style. But don't worry about it, it's just because I'm putting two videos together. Remember, it's a video, so you can do all the normal video things. Make sure you're doing the questions and or taking the notes in the nice format. Questions in the description, make sure you at least read them even if you're not doing them. But let's talk a little bit about the cell environment. So, like we said before, cells are like a baggie of water. Here's one. Oh, look at that nice baggie of water. Oh, nice lipidy type membrane on the outside, just like plastic is. But it's not just that they're water, they're actually water that's floating in a whole sea of water. So cells are in what we call an aqueous environment. That means it's a watery environment. So like we talked about yesterday, the inside and the outside of the cells is polar because they're water-based solutions. In addition to that, you have sugars, salts, etc. dissolved in both solutions. That's represented here by the blue. See the look at that nice blue in the cell. So you got all this stuff dissolved in the cytoplasm of the cell. As a result, the cytoplasm on most cells tends to have a partial negative charge. It's very important that you know that for biochemistry reasons. So then my question is, which way will the water want to move? Oh, ho, ho. And it all has to do with this issue of what we call tonicity. So we're going to compare these two solutions. We're going to compare the blue cytosol to the red aqueous environment. There's three different terms we could use. It could be isotonic, iso meaning same, ton dealing with concentration. So if it's isotonic, that means you have the same concentration. So if we have two isotonic solutions here, that means whatever stuff's dissolved in the red and whatever stuff's dissolved in the blue has equal concentration. Doesn't matter that it might be different stuff, right? This could be sugar, this could be salt, but if the concentrations of those particles are equal, then it's isotonic. Again, it doesn't matter what the stuff is as long as the concentration is equal. You could have what's called a hypertonic solution. So this is where the concentration of dissolved particles is higher. Usually when we're using these words, we're referring to the red. We're referring to the aqueous environment. So if we have a hypertonic solution, that means that they use a higher concentration of red than blue. Higher concentration of red than blue. So that's hypertonic solution. If we were to say the cells are in a hypotonic solution, you know that hypo means below, ton still means concentration. So as you can clearly see, that's where the concentration of dissolved particles is lower. So if we got our red versus blue again, that would mean that the red solution, the aqueous environment, has a much lower concentration than the cytoplasm of our cell. Again, these are comparative words. Usually it will say referring to the solution outside of the cell, but we could be talking about any two solutions. Obviously, if one is hypertonic, the other would be hypotonic. So then it gets all kinds of exciting and fun. So you have these molecules of, well, whatever this green stuff is here. And there's a higher concentration inside the cell because it's in a lower concentration solution, and that's a hypotonic solution. So if the green stuff can't go through the membrane, it wants to, but it can't. So we can't get down to a nice system of equilibrium. What will happen instead is the water will actually enter the cell. So the water will come into the cell because of osmotic pressure. So the force of the inequality between these two solutions actually causes water to be pulled in by osmotic pressure. It comes in to dilute the solution until both the solutions are isotonic to each other. And when both solutions are isotonic, the system can finally be in equilibrium. You can think of it as your cells sort of a personification. They're not happy unless they're in equilibrium, and they're going to do whatever it takes to get there. So once we're in equilibrium, we have equal movement of water out of the cell and into the cell, and the cell is then happy. So if you put yourselves in a hypertonic solution, which is what the salt water should have been,
will actually happen is because you've got this higher concentration of green molecules outside, and they want to go in, but they're blocked, so they can't. Instead, the osmotic pressure will build and actually pull the water out of the cell. Water gets pulled out of the cell by that osmotic pressure, and that's actually going to move out here to try and reach isotonicity again so that the system can again be in equilibrium where you have equal movement.
Now, I know what you're probably thinking. You're probably thinking, hey, wouldn't it be easier for the green substance to just diffuse through there to reach equilibrium? And the answer is yes, except it has to be able to do that. Diffusion is always the number one option to get a system to equilibrium, but if that can't happen, the cell's plan B would be to use osmosis.
Here's a really good example that shows it to you with real cells, so you can see what happens if you put red blood cells in a hypertonic solution. The water gets pulled out of the cell, causes cells to shrivel up, and you guessed it, they die when that happens. Same thing if you've got a hypotonic solution. You have all this water rushing into the cell, only the cells don't have anything to contain their membrane, and so they keep filling. And just like a water balloon that's gotten filled too full, they tend to pop, just like it's showing you right here. They pop, they explode, they lyse, they die. So both of these solutions are bad. What it really wants to be is an isotonic solution where you're in equilibrium, equal movement in and out. Your cells are very happy in an isotonic solution. In fact, your kidneys work very, very hard to help maintain your blood plasma at an isotonic level compared to your cells. If you drink too much water, you're risking that your cells could explode. If you have too much pop and sugary energy drinks, you're actually pulling water out of the system and making your kidneys work harder, which is bad. Be nice to your kidneys. Here's a nice picture that actually shows you real cells and what will happen in an isotonic solution. Go down to a hypotonic solution, you can see the cells exploded. Here's some cells that used to be there and now they're not there anymore. And I really love this image because you can really see these cells, they just shrivel up and die when they lose water in a hypertonic solution. Now, plant cells are a little bit different. They still don't like the hypertonic solution. Osmotic pressure builds, forces water to come out, and you can see it really just pulls the cell membrane away from the wall. It's really not good for it. While animal cells really like an isotonic solution, plant cells get really flaccid. They get limp and flopped over when they're in an isotonic solution. They actually need to be in a hypotonic solution. They need that osmotic pressure to keep pulling water in. And as water continues to enter the cell, they won't lyse like our animal cells will, because they've got that cell wall to contain the shape. What actually happens instead is the cell membrane pushes right up against the cell wall and actually causes the cell to become turgid. Turgid means it's like a fancy word for rigid or stiff. And so they need to be rigid. And when that happens in an entire plant, that's what actually makes the plant stand up straight. Right? We have a skeleton that keeps us upright. If the plants are not in a hypotonic solution, they'll flop over it. They need that turgidity in their cells. They need that pressure of the cell membrane being pushed against the cell wall. And that pressure is actually called turgid pressure. That's what makes plants stand up straight. So here's a very common application of that concept of osmosis. Let's say, for example, you have a U-shaped tube. We'll call it a U-tube. And you fill it evenly on both sides with water. In the middle of the U-tube, there's this membrane that you can see here. Here they've zoomed in on the membrane, and so you can see that there's these tiny gaps in the membrane. These little areas where small molecules, like the water, could fit through. But larger molecules, like the sugar, cannot. So they filled it up. It's really small, so the water can just maybe seep through one molecule at a time, but not a whole flow of it. The next day they come back, this is what the U-tube looks like. The original water level was right about here. And you can see that water has flowed over to fill this side and try and dilute the sugar solution over here on the right. You guys have a worksheet with this on the front and a cheat sheet reminder of what happens to animal cells in each of the three types of solutions. Answer the questions on the back for homework. If you missed class or you couldn't pick it up, links in the description. Thanks for watching, everybody. Enjoy your weekend.